Tuesday, May 28th, Michelle Rogers, Director in Community Engagement and Editorial Training from the Southeast Michigan Media Lab, had the pleasure of being on the Lucy Ann Lance Show on 1290 WLBY. Michelle spoke of her work with the Southeast Michigan Media Lab and how social media has become a primary tool in journalism.
The Lucy Ann Lance Show, along with Dean Erskine, our producer, Elise Shea. Good morning, everyone. Welcome into this Tuesday, 28th day of May, 2013. The Southeast Community Media Lab, an initiative of Heritage Media, provides a space where the community can work one-on-one with a trained multimedia journalist, bringing the audience inside the newsroom to share their voice and serve as news-sharing partners. Joining us this morning is Michelle Rogers, an award-winning journalist and editor who reported on Dexter from 1992 to 2000 and served as editor of the Dexter Leader from 2000 to 2006, most recently serving as managing editor and now running this community outreach project for Heritage Media. And we welcome you to 1290 WLBY. This is a really interesting initiative that Heritage started. How did it all begin?
Well, we had another newspaper in our chain who was Matt Dorenzo, and I believe he's in New Haven or Connecticut. He started a media lab there, and then our company asked for initiatives similar to that. So they invited everybody to put together a proposal. And my proposal, there are four out of Michigan. Mine was the only one in Michigan that got approved for funding, and I made it part of my Idea Lab project. So I'm back in 2010, I was named to the Idea Lab as one of 18 people chosen from across the chain to experiment with technology to move journalism forward. So I initially started with podcasting, and I did a walking historic tour of downtown Saline. I worked with the Saline Historical Society and a professor at Eastern Michigan University, Michael McVeigh. We did podcasting, featured various buildings, historic sites in downtown Saline, and then included old photos, photos of today, a map so people could find the locations, and then the people from the Historical Society did podcasts where they explained the history behind the buildings. That was my first project. So this was my second project, and I launched it last April, and I approached Spark East, and they welcomed the idea. They thought it was a perfect fit for the business incubator there, and we started off as virtual tenants. And just recently, when my position as managing editor was eliminated in February, I was named director of community engagement editorial training for all of Michigan. And then they placed me there at the lab, and they said, we're going to have you here full time. This is your office. We want to sort of beef up this news sharing partnerships with the community. And we're looking for bloggers. I've been asked to recruit 100 bloggers this year. In the last 3 months, I've recruited 43.
Fantastic.
So we're, yeah, thank you. We're well on our way, and we're looking for more. And then also just to train citizens in journalism so they can become news sharing partners. So let's say if you're having an event in your community, you can come in the lab, you don't feel comfortable writing up your own press release, I'll teach you, I'll walk you through the process. And then I'll suggest maybe that you shoot some photos and put together a photo slideshow. I'll show you how to do that on Flickr. You want to put together a video promoting the event or during the event, come in, I'll help you edit it. And then just the various social media tools that they can use.
And what's interesting about Heritage doing this, it doesn't just have to go on one of the Heritage publications or online. It can go anywhere.
Correct. I mean, there are no sort of rules. They don't have to share the information with us. They can share it with AnnArbor.com or another publication or your radio show. We're just trying to help people. It's kind of community outreach, you know, provide an outlet and train them in these tools.
Is this a distinct change in Heritage's mission as a news gathering operation?
I don't know if I'd say that. I mean, we're part of 21st Century Media, which used to be the Journal Register Company. Mm-hmm. And when John Payton took over as CEO back in, I think it was 2009, it became more of an open sort of newsroom. And that was encouraged by him. He gave all of our reporters flip cams to start, you know, and we all got into video. And then he encouraged us, everybody, to be on social media, on Twitter and Facebook and all of that. And so I think that it's just sort of evolution. And I think that's across the industry. You're seeing that, I think, at every newspaper or media company.
There's no doubt about it. The world has changed, the world of journalism. Those of us in radio, we've known for a long time there was much more than print out there, even if print didn't want to admit it. But that has all changed. Now everyone is embracing each other's platforms. There are so many ways to speak out. The world gets its information in a multitude of ways, so why not embrace all the different technology that's out there? We podcast our interviews online. You have to be able to do this. The thought, though, of having the public participate in that as bloggers, as news contributors, is, I think, the biggest change of all.
I'm Elise Waller, reporting for the Southeast Michigan Media Lab.